It's okay. In the previous problems, numerical problems, we discussed the force of friction on an inclined plane, right? So in that case, you are given that on this inclined plane, we have a weight of this block was 196.2, right? And we have find that this block was moving downward to the plane, right? So we also have find the vertical component. I mean, the component of this weight perpendicular to this inclined plane is 196.2 cosine of 20 degree, and the component on this side is 196.2 sine of 20 degree, right? And this was the force of friction on this side, and mu s is 0.3, mu k is 0.2. so let us suppose that now in this case, in the previous conditions, we have find that 196 point this component is greater than as compared to the maximum force of friction, so that's why block will move on the downward side. But if I say that, let us add it the same Gaussians. If I say that on this block, the same block, a force is also acting on this side, right? So let us suppose that this force is 30 newton, right? 30 newton is acting on this side, and we have to find, and again you are given that its mass is 20 kg. So in fact, we will convert this into newton weight, so multiply with 9.81. so now this is the condition that we have. So now this force P is acting on this block, so we have to find whether this block is moving on this side or moving downward side, or maybe the block is at rest. That we have to find mu s again 0.3, mu k is again 0.2, and also find force of friction, right? So now the direction of force of friction will be, as we know that it is opposite to the motions. If the block is moving downward to the plane, then the force of friction will be will act upward to the plane. If this block is moving upward, then again the force of friction is will be the direction of force of friction is downward to the plane. So maybe the block is at rest, but still there could be a direction of force of friction, either it is upward to the plane or downward to the plane. So that will depend upon the direction of the force, right? So now let us find it. So in this case, again we can resolve the component of this weight on this side is 196.2 cosine of 20 degree. So the angle will be 20 degree here, right? And the component of 196.2 on this side, so that will be 196.2 sine of 20 degree. So this component, right? Now okay, just in law, let us draw the free body diagram here. So on this block, the one component is due to its weight, so that will act on this side, that is 196.2 sine of 20 degree, right? The second component is of the weight is on the downward side, so that is 196.2 cosine of 20 degree, right? And we also have a one force which is applied on this side, so that force is 30 newton, right? So now we have to find whether this block is at rest or it is moving upward to the plane or downward to the plane, that we have to find. Okay, so now in this question, first find this is the normal reaction force. So this normal reaction force is balanced by 196.2 cosine of 20 degree. So we can write it as a n equals to 196.2 cosine of 20 degree, right? So it means n equals to, we have 184.36, right? Now this in the second portion, so these forces are balanced. Your block is not going to move upward or downward to this plane on this side. So that's why n is balanced by 196 point cos of 20 degree, right? But the second thing is, we have to find the net force on this on along this inclined plane. So you have to find the net force along this inclined plane. So if I let us find the net force along inclined plane, right? So we can write, so you can write okay, 196 point sine of 20 degree. So I have taken it as a positive. It means I have taken the forces which is acting on this side as a positive and which is acting on this side as a negative. So I will take 30 as a negative, right? So you will find that okay, now 196 point sine 20, so what is this one? So what is the value that we have for this one? So it is 67.104 minus 30, so that is equals to 37.104, right? So this is the net force. So it means if I redraw again block on this side, so we know that 196.2 sine 20 degree is greater than 30 newton, so it means the net force which is acting on this side is how much? So it is 37.104, right? So now this is the net force which is acting on this side downward to the plane. From this we can say that the force of friction will be opposite to the this force. So at this moment only we have find the direction of force of friction, as the net force on this block along the plane is on this side. So it means the force of friction will be opposite to this one. So so till now we only have find the direction of force of friction, but still we have not find its magnitude. So now we have to find whether this 37.104 force which is on this side is enough to move this block downward to the plane, that we have to find. So again, find your maximum force of friction in this case. So that is equals to mu s into n, right? So mu s is 0.3 and normal reaction force is 184.36. So that is equals to, so the maximum force of friction is 55.31. So now compare this F max with the net force, this one. So it means, so you can conclude that F max is greater than F net force. So what does it mean? So F max is 55.31 and F net is 37.104. If your F net is greater than F max, then this body will move on the downward side, right? So what does it mean? So it means the block is at rest, it's not moving, right? So if it is at rest, not moving, we have find the actual force of friction, the already we have find the direction force of direction for force of friction, and the magnitude of force of friction will be how much, as it is less than the F maximum. So it means if your force of friction, this one, so it means it is not moving downward, so it means the force of friction balances this 37.104. So it means F force of friction is also your 37.104 and direction is on this side, right?